Hi, you guys. It's Yaz, and today I'm going to talk about five creepy things the narcissist will do when the relationship ends with you. What do you think that narcissist is doing after they leave you or you leave them? Well, they're not sitting home crying over you. So I'm going to sit here and tell you the creepy things that a narcissist will do once the relationship ends. Number one, now keep in mind, I may go over five, you guys, because I added extra things that I thought about of what a narcissist does when the relationship ends. Number one, understand this. When a relationship ends between you and the narcissist is not going to cry over you because the narcissist was never all in. They always had other things going on. And usually towards the breakdown of the relationship, before the relationship completely ends, that narcissist was grooming somebody on the side because they observed and saw that the relationship was going to end. And so they had to have that security blanket on the side so that they could monkey branch off to somebody else. But what they're going to do, you guys, is they're going to have sex right away. All right. A narcissist is not going to sit home. They're not going to, you know, get into a depression. That's the last thing they want to do, is be alone and to self-reflect, because that would mean that they would have to take shame. And a narcissist never wants to feel shame. They want to feel pleasure. They want to feel good. So, you know, that's why a lot of narcissists have addictions as well, to mask the unhappiness within themselves, to get rid of that unhappiness. So they're going to be looking to have sex to get back at you, all right? They probably were having sex when they were in the relationship with you, but they're going to look to go have sex to feel better about themselves because they don't want to feel like they lost anything. And sex is an instant, you know, high for them. So they may try to have sex with anybody just to feel better, okay? And not feel alone and abandoned. You know, they're going to hit up every supply that they know of because they like to have a multitude of supply. They like to have their phone ringing. They never want to feel, remember what I told you, they don't want to feel alone, because when they're alone, they start to get depressed and then start to feel shame and all of that. All right. They're also going to, you know, this is the time that they're going to hoover their exes. All right. So when you're, now think about it like this, when your ex comes back and starts hoovering you, you know why? Because they usually are having problems with whoever they're with. So that's when they're not doing good, that's when they're going to come back to their exes. So when you break up with the narcissist, they're going to hoover their exes and see if they can get the supply out of them. Even if they have another supply on the side, a different supply, they're still going to hoover their exes. So they're going to be looking to have sex to make themselves feel better. They're going to be hoovering their exes. They're going to, you know, be giving more attention to the new supply that they lined up before the relationship ended. They're going to be all over social media in inbox, okay? Nobody loves social media more than a narcissist who's hunting for supply. So they're going to be on social media. They're going to be hitting every inbox that they can because they've got to feel better about themselves. Now the relationship ended with you. That is, you know, shame to them. So they've got to get rid of that shame. And in order to get rid of that shame, they've got to make themselves feel good, right? So that's why if they get this validation from all this other supply, however they get it, whether it's hoovering their exes, whether it's going in inbox, whether it's going on dating apps, they feel better about themselves when they're getting that attention from other people so that they could sit there and, you know, justify that they weren't the problem. There's nothing wrong with them. Look at all these people that like them. Look at all these people that want to be with them. Okay. So they're going to be all over social media. The other thing they're going to be doing is enjoying their freedom. When they were with you, yeah, they did their thing on the side, but they didn't have complete freedom because you may have been watching them or around. Now they have complete freedom, you know, if they haven't completely jumped to the other supply. And what are they going to do? they're going to be going out a lot. They're not going to be sitting home, all right? Wherever they go to hang out, they may go, you know, out to the bars. They're going to go where they can be around a lot of supply and meet a lot of other people. They won't be sitting home. That I could tell you. They won't be sitting home. See, this is the difference between a narcissist and a narcissistic abuse survivor. The narcissist goes on moving forward, okay? Whereas the narcissistic abuse survivor is trying to heal and pick up the pieces. A narcissistic abuse survivor may be home and depressed and may not want to leave the house, okay? Whereas the narcissist is, you know, they're just going to say, well, you were crazy. There was something wrong with you, and I'm glad to get rid of you. And they're going to right away want to be around other people that will lift that, that will lift them up, all right? What's another thing the narcissist is going to do when the relationship ends? Well, they're going to be, you know, tracking your social media, seeing what you're posting. They want to see posts that you're upset, okay? Because it's going to make them feel better. In a narcissist's mind, a narcissist feels generally you're not going anywhere, okay? They feel that, you know, you'll be back. So what a narcissist does when the relationship ends is they're going to be out there having fun, okay? Again, remember what I said. They're not going to be sitting home. They're not going to be depressed. They're going to be going out, having a good time for themselves, maybe having a lot of sex, you know, trying to lift themselves up. They may, you know, be drinking. They may be drugging. They're going to try to, you know, numb out the unhappiness of losing you, okay? Because not necessarily because they loved you, but because they lost the supply from you. And any breakup that they have is a failure, all right? And they don't want to feel like they're a failure or any shame. So they're going to want to make themselves feel better, and they do it with addictions, with sex, with drinking, some with drugging, you know, just, you know, making themselves feel good, that instant gratification to try to lift themselves up and block out all the shame. They never want to feel like they did anything wrong to cause the breakup. All of that, the result of the breakup was your fault. No matter, even if they cheated on you, you caught them, you got rid of them, you threw them out, they're still going to say it's your fault, okay? That they did whatever they did because of you, all right? Because maybe you didn't give them enough attention, or you didn't give them enough sex, or you weren't there for them, or you worked too hard. They'll justify anything and concoct it, you know, in their minds, that you are the problem for the breakup, all right? But again, they don't want that alone time, because alone time will make them think about all these things and could make them self-reflect, and that's something they don't want to do. So instead, they go out. They just say, you're crazy. The problem was you. They go out and they say, fine, you don't want to be with me. They go out and they have a good time. Or they're spending more time with the other supply that was on the side. Okay. And now what happens is they go to that new supply and they repeat the pattern that they did with you. So whatever they did with you, you could trust and believe they're going to do with the new supply. They're going to, you know, show them a lot of attention. They're going to be consistent with them. They're going to love bomb the hell out of them. So whatever they did with you initially, they're going to do with the new supply. And then they're going to get tired of the new supply or bored of the new supply. And it's going to be the same pattern that went with you is going to happen with the new supply. Okay. And then when the new supply and them don't work out or there's problems, that's when the narcissist may hoover you. Now, not all narcissists will hoover you. Okay. There's a couple of different reasons why they won't, and I'll do a podcast on that. But, you know, they could hoover you 10 years down the line and come back. It depends on what's going on in that narcissist's life, if they need you, all right? And if they feel that they could get over on you and that, you know, you don't have strong boundaries and that, you know, it's not like you see through the narcissist and they know absolutely they can't get anywhere with you. But again, what they're going to do is they're going to be with that new supply, spending more time. So now they're with the new supply, right, guys? And what people don't understand is they think, oh, you know, you break up with the narcissist, the relationship ends, and they're with the new supply and they're living life and happily ever after, right? I always tell people, you don't know what goes on behind closed doors. People that seem happy, you know, and one of the things that a narcissist does is they'll post that they're happy on social media. They love to post, oh, my life is great now. I got rid of her. I got rid of him. You know, they were crazy. They had mental issues. Now look at my life. I'm so happy. And some of them may post the new supply and some of them may not post the new supply, depending on the situation. But whatever it is, they're going to post on social media about how happy they are. And they're going to post themselves out and having a great time and, you know, enjoying their life. Why? Because they feel that you're watching. A narcissist knows. They know that you're watching, all right? That's why it's important to block them. You want to let them know that, you know what? I don't really give a shit what you're doing. You are done, okay? The fact of the matter is, you did not respect me. You broke my boundaries. You were a liar, a deceiver, and a gaslighter, and I don't want you in your life, and I could give a rat's ass what you're doing, all right? This is why you have to block them, because if you don't block them, that narcissist thinks that you still care and that they could come back, all right? So they're going to be all over social media. They're going to be out having a good time. They're going to be with the new supply. But what you don't realize is even though they're with the new supply, they're going to have backup to the new supply, all right? Because now the new supply is the main source, right? But they're not going to trust one supply. They've got to have a backup to the new supply. So they're still going to be out there prospecting other backups in case things don't work out with the new supply. They're still going to be on social media, inbox. They may be on dating apps all over the place, talking to people, meeting up with people, having situationships on the side. So, you know, they're going to want a bunch of people that they can hit up if they need to, all right? See, a narcissist never wants to be put in a position of solitude, of loneliness. They don't ever want to feel like the phone isn't ringing because then they feel like a loser, and a narcissist never ever wants to feel like a loser, okay? So, like I told you, just because they look happy with the new supply, understand, they want you to think that, all right? Of course, they know you're watching. They want you to think that. So they're very careful what they post or what they tell people that gets back to you. But behind closed doors, whatever they did with you, they will do with them in time, in time. That's why I say just kick back. They will reap whatever they sow, whether it's you or anybody else. Okay, you guys? So let's recap, you know, the five sneaky things a narcissist does when the relationship ends, all right? They're going to be looking to have sex, all right? A lot of sex because they're upset, they're angry, and it makes them feel good, and it makes them feel good too, knowing that they're getting back at you, having plenty of sex, all right? They don't want to feel depressed. They're going to, number two, be hitting up every supply or jumping to the new supply that they were grooming towards the end of the relationship with you before it actually broke, all right? They're going to be hoovering exes. They're going to be in all the inboxes on social media, dating apps. They're going to be watching your social media, all right? They're going to be love bombing the new supply and repeating the pattern. And one last thing that I would like to add that a narcissist does when the relationship ends is, this is a given, they're going to smear you, okay? Now, they're going to smear you to the flying monkeys. That's their people, their supporters. Of course, they need that cheering squad, like, oh, I was dealing with her, him, and they were crazy. I'm so glad to get rid of them. And what they're going to do is they're going to maybe twist it around and make like they got rid of you, Okay. They're going to say things like, well, I didn't want them anyway, or I couldn't care less towards the end of the relationship or anything like that. You know, that's, they're going to try to twist it around. Like they got rid of you because you were crazy, or they're going to, if they don't do that, then they're going to play the victim that they did everything for you. And you're so unappreciative of everything they did for you. You're this wicked mental case. You're a mental case. There's something wrong with you. This is what narcissists do to make themselves feel better. Now, understand this. The more they smear you, the more you know you hurt that narcissist to the fucking core, okay? That's why they gotta smear you. They gotta smear the shit out of you because they're so angry because you hurt them. So that should give you a little satisfaction in the sense that if they're smearing you a lot, it means you hurt them, okay? Because you don't want them. So they're going to smear you. And like I said, they may do it publicly on their social media to try to embarrass, to try to humiliate you, okay? They may make it public because they know that you could be watching their social media. So there's two ways they'll handle the social media. They may publicly smear you and make you out to be the villain and, you know, this crazy lunatic. Or they're going to make like it doesn't even affect them. And they're just going to post that they're living the life of Riley, that they're having a great life and they're enjoying their life. And, you know, they're in this new relationship and they're going to make like you never even existed. All right. To make you feel less about yourself. All right. That's why I tell you, do not. I know it's hard, but don't watch the narcissist's social media. Okay. Because it's going to do nothing but trigger you. Who cares what a toxic narcissist says? Who cares? All right. Anything that comes out of their mouth doesn't mean shit. Okay. And it just, you know, rehashes all of this in your brain. So it will be harder for you to heal. The way to heal is to get away from these people and not be reminded of them. All right. So this is why you don't go on their social media. So yeah, these are all the things that all the creepy things that the narcissist will do when the relationship ends with you. And, you know, you shouldn't worry about what the narcissist is doing because, you know, they're not, like I said, they're not going to be sitting there crying and worrying about you initially. All right. They're going to be busy. That narcissist is going to be busy when that relationship ends. But your, you know, your retribution, or you will get back, per se, your karma in time. In time, that narcissist will realize that they lost something that you had. They don't necessarily have those kinds of feelings because they were never all in. They never submitted to really feel that kind of emotion. But in time, they're going to miss whatever you had to offer them. They miss supply. They don't miss people. So, but they're going to try to keep themselves busy so that they don't fall into that depression. And, you know, it's not going, a lot of times, you guys, a narcissist may not come back for a very long time. You could have a narcissist come back over 10 years later, all right? You'd be surprised. That happened to me. You could have a narcissist come back. I had a narcissist come back from, you know, when I was dealing with him in my 20s, come back and hit me up on Facebook. And I was like, is this guy for real? Okay. So, I mean, they could come back at any time, depending on what's going on in their lives, all right? But you need to focus in on what you need to do to move forward. You look forward. You do not look back, all right? You want to, you know, you want to build a new life for yourself. So you focus in on what you need to do for yourself in order to better your life, how to progress in your life, what you should be doing, the things you should be doing on a daily basis to heal and to be happy. Okay. So that's why it's good to make a list of what you should be doing. All right. So those are all the creepy things that the narcissist does, okay? I hope that helps you guys. If it does, hit the subscribe button, share the podcast. If you're looking for one-on-one confidential phone coaching, go to the link in the bio at askyaz.wixsite.com. If you're confused, you don't know if you're dealing with a narcissist, if you don't know what kind of narcissist you're dealing with, are they a covert, malignant, grandiose narcissist? If you don't know the behaviors, is this a narcissist you're dealing with, or you don't know how to deal with them, and you need clarity, check out the link in the bio for one-on-one confidential coaching at askyaz.wixsite.com for more information. If you want a lot more videos on this, where I have almost 5,000 videos and reels on covert narcissists, discard, the manipulation tactics that they use, check out my YouTube channel at the Game Exposed podcast. For more posts, check out Facebook, Instagram at the Game EXP 123. Any other pages, fake pages, and TikTok is the Game Exposed. And have a great day, you guys.